the crafting video. And as soon as I can get the wire unwrapped, we will get after it. But let's go ahead and switch to the proper camera here. Get it set up. Okay. There we go. So I'm working on getting this started. There it is. They did not wrap it right on this one. The where the wire starts, right up here, the saran wrap should have started up, and did not start up right there. It started further back and then ripped off. So, got to get it started again. Get my tweezers here. Actually, make it where you guys can see it as well. Okay, I may actually be able to get this lifted out. There we go. Now we've got our black wire freed. So now we can clip off a section Hold on, I thought I had my wire cutters right here by me. Must have put them back for some reason. Alright, so we need something to cut the wire with, in this case needle nose, and something to strip it with. Just cut off a portion of wire and then go ahead and strip one end of it with the wire strippers. So, want to get enough off so you've got some room to work with. There we go. So there's our wire. And there's the blank part, or empty little rubber shroud. Now, the first thing I'm going to do is kind of wrap these around each other because they are little fibrous metal hairs. And I want them to stay together, not flay out like they were. So that will keep them together. And this is going to be one end over here on the battery box, and the other end is going to be attached to one of these screws on the switch. And I'm not going to use the entire length here. I'm going to take it down a bit lower. So let's just kind of twist the wire down there as well. I realize I should have started this lower earlier. And that should do it for the end that this is going on. So let's just clip off the majority of that excess. So we now have that. A little bit smaller length. And that's what we want. So now we just knock the excess off of our clippers. And let's go ahead and fit this one onto the battery connector. And to do that, to kind of get it up into that little hole there to make connection. So get our needle nose . Finish the process that we had started there. Also, let's lift this up just a little bit so we can actually get it up under there. we go. Okay, I've got it started. And now we can take our needle nose again. And I know I'm kind of out of frame here. I'm kind of having to work with things as I'm able to. But we want to pull it around like so, so that it now basically hooks in through that little hole there. And now when we add in our solder, which we will do in a moment, it will have a better chance of making a good connection for everything there. Also, let's just give that a little wrap around as well. So there we go, there is our black to the battery compartment. Now we also need to strip off the other end of our black wire. There we go. And this will be going to the other component. We're not going to worry with that right now. What we are going to worry with is getting the red wire dealt with. And that means I gotta fight this again. Actually, let's just get this soldered down. I'm not really feeling like that pain again. The entire break I was working on that. So let me just get my soldering iron out. And let's get it plugged in. And it can start heating up. And I will go and get the sponge. Where'd that fall off to? It's around here somewhere. Hold on. Because that is a important part of all of this. There it is. Alright, just wet this down a little bit, and I'll be right back. And I'm back. And there's the sponge. So what we're looking to do is take some of our nice leaded solder and basically get it to adhere that joint. So for this, I use my helping hands. Let me go grab those. Okay, so let's get things set up here with the helping hands. I'm not going to use them for the solder, but just to hold this in place for me. How's the iron heating up? Looks like it's heating up okay. See if it'll melt the solder yet. Not yet. Getting there, but still needs a little bit more time. So while we are looking at giving it a bit more time to get ready, how about we use the other red that I had before. This will allow us to get both done for the switch part of it, instead of just one of them. So let's get a length of wire, clip it, and then we will strip it at the ends. So there's one end. Let's do the other. Got both ends stripped back. And we will get the black soldered in and then hook up the red. See if the iron is hot enough now to melt. There we go. We are plenty hot enough. So let's get this turned at an angle that I can work with here. looks. Needs a bit more work on it. Okay. Maybe try it from a different angle here. I don't even need this, do I? Probably not. I'm gonna say that's good enough. That should make a solid connection. So let's just clean it up a little bit more. And now let's get the red through as well here. Again, have to pry this up a little bit. Able to get the wire up in. Okay, try this one more time. That should do it. Now I think we've got a large enough gap to thread this through. Yes, indeed we do. And now I'll just bring this on around. Give it a twist like we did on the black. And then just apply a bit of solder to it, like we did the black again. Thank you. Ow. That's gonna leave a mark. Or should I say it already has? Yep. And that's why we don't get the soldering iron so close to our thumb. But we do have some solder on there, so we can finish this up from a little bit of a safer angle. Okay, we will call that it for the crafting session. Hey everyone, hope you enjoyed the video you just watched. If you did, right here, let's move my head over. There we go, right here is going to be another video in the future for the next in this particular series. And over here is going to be the previous video in this series, along with a subscribe button down below it. So feel free to give that a hit, and be sure to like the video if you liked it, dislike it if you didn't. And let's see. Oh yeah, be sure to leave a comment. I'd appreciate knowing what your thoughts are. Until the next one, everyone.